This video doesn't have an intro. The scriptwriter was too lazy to write one, but it's cool as it is. Here are 10 mind-blowing facts about Jupiter. Number 10. Jupiter is the largest planet in our solar system and is almost twice as massive as all the other planets combined. Studying Jupiter's moons has been instrumental in helping us understand the giant planet's mass. By observing the orbital periods and mean distances of Jupiter's moons, astronomers can infer the mass of the planet. Since Jupiter is so massive, it exerts a significant gravitational pull on its moons, causing them to move swiftly in their orbits. Callisto, one of Jupiter's major moons, is particularly useful in calculating the planet's mass. By measuring Callisto's mean distance from Jupiter, which is 1,822,000 kilometers, almost 4.898 lunar distances, and its orbital period, which is 16.689 days, smaller than the lunar period, scientists can plug these values into the famous third Kepler's equation that gives Jupiter's mass in Earth masses. It is found to be almost 314 times more massive than the Earth. Can you believe it? It's huge! This method works because the gravitational force between Jupiter and Callisto is proportional to their masses and the square of the distance between them. So by measuring the orbital distance and period of the moon, scientists can calculate the strength of the gravitational force, which in turn provides a measure of Jupiter's mass. In addition to Callisto, scientists can also use the other three major moons of Jupiter, Io, Europa, and Ganymede, to determine the planet's mass. Each moon provides its own set of data, allowing scientists to cross-check their calculations and refine their measurements. Knowing Jupiter's mass is not just a matter of scientific curiosity. It has important implications for our understanding of the formation and evolution of the solar system. Jupiter's massive gravitational influence has shaped the orbits of the other planets and has helped to deflect many asteroids and comets away from the inner solar system, reducing the number of collisions that Earth has experienced. Studying Jupiter's moons has given us a valuable tool for computing the planet's mass. By observing the swift movements of these moons, we can infer the immense gravitational pull of the giant planet and gain insights into the workings of our solar system. Number 9. Jupiter has the shortest day of any planet, rotating once on its axis every 9 hours and 56 minutes or so. Okay, so first things first, let's talk about what a day even is. We all know that it is a cycle of daytime to nighttime, right? Well, that's called a solar day, and on Earth it's around 24 hours. But get this, sometimes it's a few minutes longer or shorter because Earth's orbit is not like a perfect circle or whatever. But wait, there's more. You can also measure a day by counting how long it takes for a planet to spin around once. This is called a sidereal day. On Earth, that's almost 23 hours and 56 minutes. Now you may be thinking, what about the other planets? Do they have normal days like us Earthlings? The answer is a resounding no. Take Venus for example. It spins so slowly that one day there lasts almost 243 Earth days. That's longer than a year, y'all. And because Venus is closer to the Sun, a year on Venus only lasts 225 Earth days. So basically, Venus residents only get to see two sunrises a year. Bummer, right? And don't even get me started on Mercury. It takes 58.6 Earth days for it to spin once on its axis, but its year is only 88 Earth days long. I don't know about you, but that seems like some kind of time warp nonsense to me. Now let's talk about the gas giant planets. Pay attention, because Jupiter is one of them. They don't even have solid surfaces, but they do have some crazy clouds and liquid metallic hydrogen and helium layers. Jupiter, for instance, has different regions that rotate at different rates. The equatorial cloud belt rotates at 9 hours and 56 minutes, while the poles move a bit faster at 9 hours and 50 minutes. The canonical day length on Jupiter is determined by its magnetic field and is 9 hours and 55 minutes long. Finally, we've got Saturn, Uranus, and Neptune. Saturn has a day length of 10 hours and 33 minutes. Uranus is at 17 hours and 14 minutes. And Neptune comes in at around 15 hours. When it comes to days on other planets, it's a mixed bag of weirdness. But hey, at least we Earthlings have our good old 24-hour days, right? Number 8. Jupiter has the strongest magnetic field of any planet in our solar system, 20,000 times stronger than Earth's. Did you know that? It seems impossible, but it's true. Can you imagine how powerful that must be? But that's not all. Jupiter's magnetic field is also much more complex than Earth's. Some aspects of Jupiter's fields have no earthly counterpart. It's believed that this intense and complex magnetic field is related to Jupiter's rapid rotation and its large metallic interior. This donut-shaped field contains giant versions of the Earth's Van Allen belts that trap high-energy particles, mostly electrons and protons. But because of the forces associated with the rapid rotation of Jupiter and its magnetic field, these belts are flattened into plasma sheets. And get this, the field rotates with the approximately 9-hour rotational period of the planet. Jupiter's four largest moons orbit through this region and are affected by it. Io, one of Jupiter's moons, has multiple active volcanoes on its surface that spew gas particles into space. These particles eventually diffuse into the region surrounding Jupiter and become trapped in its magnetic field. It's both responsible for many of the charged particles in Jupiter's magnetic field and is being eroded by collisions with those particles as it orbits Jupiter. But here's the really cool part. Intense auroras have been observed on Jupiter. This takes us to fact number 7. Jupiter produces the most powerful auroras in the solar system, with auroras at its poles being hundreds of times brighter than Earth's. On Earth, charged particles trapped in our magnetic field originate from the solar wind. But since Jupiter's magnetosphere deflects the solar wind well away from Jupiter's atmosphere, the charged particles responsible for Jupiter's auroras must come from another source. They are thought to originate from the innermost moons orbiting in the region of a strong magnetic field and trapped charged particles. So there you have it. Jupiter's magnetic field is not only much stronger than the Earth's, but also much more complex. It's a truly fascinating phenomenon in our solar system. Number 6. The Great Red Spot. A giant storm on Jupiter has been raging for at least 350 years and is larger than the size of Earth. NASA has been keeping a close eye on this Great Red Spot because, let's be honest, who wouldn't want to keep tabs on a massive storm that's been raging for over 3 centuries? As I told you, this thing is bigger than Earth, so you know it's a pretty big deal. The storm itself is a swirling, churning, chaotic mass of gas that makes even the most intense hurricane on Earth look like a slight breeze. And it's not just any old gas. We're talking about hydrogen and helium, the same stuff that fills those party balloons that you accidentally let go of and watch float up into the sky. Scientists aren't entirely sure what causes the Great Red Spot to keep on keeping on, but they think it has something to do with the planet's enormous size and the way it spins. It's like if you were to hop on a merry-go-round and start spinning around really fast. Eventually, you might start to feel a little dizzy, and if you kept going long enough, you might even start to see spots. But in Jupiter's case, those spots have turned into a massive, swirling monster of a storm that refuses to quit. Now, we know what you're thinking. But wait, doesn't a storm like this cause some serious damage to the planet? And the answer is, kind of. While the Great Red Spot is certainly a force to be reckoned with, Jupiter is such a ginormous planet that it's able to absorb the storm's energy without breaking a sweat. It's like if you were to punch a really big marshmallow. Sure, you might make a dent, but the marshmallow would still be mostly intact. Please don't actually try this, by the way. We don't condone violence against marshmallows. So there you have it, folks. The Great Red Spot may be a massive, never-ending storm on a distant planet, but it's still kind of amazing. And who knows, maybe one day we'll figure out exactly why it's been going strong for so long. In the meantime, we'll just keep watching and hoping that Jupiter doesn't decide to launch its own version of a hurricane towards Earth. If you're enjoying the video, please push the like button and maybe subscribe to the channel. Thanks. Number 5. Jupiter has 92 moons, the largest being Ganymede, which is larger than the planet Mercury. The moons of Jupiter are a fascinating topic for space enthusiasts and astronomers alike. They offer a unique insight into the formation and evolution of the solar system's largest planet, and the recent discovery of 12 new moons adds yet another layer to this complex puzzle. The four largest moons of Jupiter are known as the Galilean moons, named after the astronomer Galileo Galilei, who first observed them in 1610. These moons, Io, Europa, Ganymede, and Callisto, are some of the most geologically active bodies in our solar system, with volcanic activity, ice geysers, and subsurface oceans. Particularly Ganymede, it is the largest moon in our solar system, bigger than the planet Mercury and the dwarf planet Pluto. On the other hand, the 12 new moons recently discovered around Jupiter are much smaller than the Galilean moons, with diameters ranging from less than a mile to around 2 miles. They're also much farther from the planet, with some taking up to 2 years to complete an orbit. In fact, two of the moons have retrograde orbits, meaning they move in the opposite direction to Jupiter's rotation. The discovery of these new moons was made possible by advances in technology that allow astronomers to detect fainter and more distant objects. It is likely that there are still many more moons and smaller objects orbiting Jupiter that have yet to be discovered. Studying the moons of Jupiter can help us understand the formation and evolution of the solar system, and may even provide clues to the potential for life elsewhere in the universe. With the recent discovery of 12 new moons, there is no doubt that there is still much to learn about this gas giant and its fascinating satellite system. Number 4. The temperature of Jupiter's core is hotter than the surface of the Sun, reaching up to 36,000 degrees Fahrenheit. Jupiter, the largest planet in our solar system, has a unique composition dominated by hydrogen and helium, with traces of methane and ammonia. With similar elements to the Sun, it's plausible that Jupiter could have been a double star companion. But to undergo nuclear fusion and become a star, Jupiter would have had to be at least 80 times more massive. Jupiter's dense atmosphere, extending down to several hundred miles, is pulled towards its surface due to its intense gravity. Closer to the surface, gases become denser and may form into slurry. The Pioneer 10 and 11 space probes discover that Jupiter's core is made largely of liquid hydrogen, and there is no clear boundary between the surface and atmospheric layers. The rocky core is situated deep beneath the surface and is very hot, estimated to be around 36,000 degrees Fahrenheit, due to gravitational compression, which increases temperatures. However, Jupiter is small and cold for nuclear fusion reactions to occur, and it lacks the necessary conditions to evolve into a star. Number 3. The gravity on Jupiter is 2.5 times stronger than on Earth, making it impossible for humans to stand on the surface. If only there was one. The gravity on Jupiter is greater than the gravity on Earth because Jupiter is more massive. Although Jupiter is a great deal larger in size, its surface gravity is just 2.4 times that of the surface gravity of Earth. This is because Jupiter is mostly made up of gases. If you weigh 100 pounds on Earth, you would weigh 240 pounds on Jupiter, assuming you could find some place to, well, stand. Number 2. Jupiter is responsible for sweeping up and diverting asteroids and comets that would otherwise collide with Earth. Imagine Jupiter as a goalkeeper, protecting the other planets in our solar system like a boss. Sure, it may have migrated a little from where it was originally formed, but who hasn't made a move or two in their cosmic career? When Jupiter wanders towards the stars, it's like a giant goalkeeper sprinting towards the ball, ready to block anything that comes its way. And let me tell you, that guy is one heck of a reach. But when Jupiter stays put, it becomes the ultimate gatekeeper to the other planets. Hey, nobody's getting past this guy. It's like Jupiter is standing guard at the entrance to a nightclub, checking IDs and making sure nobody too rowdy gets in. It even vacuums up any asteroids or comets that dare to stray too close, earning the name vacuum cleaner of the solar system. Seriously, who needs a Roomba when you have Jupiter? And don't even get me started on the asteroid belt between Mars and Jupiter. That's like Jupiter's own personal trophy case, showing off all the asteroids it's blocked from barreling into a planet. Talk about a power move. But Jupiter isn't just a big, strong goalkeeper. It's also got some serious moves. With its gravity, it can radically alter the orbits of small bodies that stray too close, hurling them on long orbits that take hundreds or even thousands of years to return. It's like watching a goalie expertly clear the ball to the other end of the field, preparing for an epic counterattack. Of course, Jupiter isn't perfect. Sometimes it sends objects hurling towards the inner planets, like a goalie having an off day and accidentally scoring on their own team. But hey, a few dings and bruises are worth it if it means bringing ingredients for life to Earth. And let's be real, it's not like Jupiter meant to take out the dinosaurs. That was just a freak accident. So here's to you, Jupiter, the ultimate goalie, protecting our little planetary team and keeping us safe from harm. Who needs a superhero when you've got a giant gas giant on your side? Number 1. We will soon launch a probe to visit Jupiter and its moons. It's called JUICE. No, JUICE is not something you drink. It stands for Jupiter Icy Moons Explorer. And the spacecraft will carry a suite of scientific instruments to study the gas giant and its moons in detail. It is one of the most ambitious space exploration projects to be undertaken in recent years. The mission aims to unlock many of the mysteries surrounding the formation and evolution of our solar system. The mission is being undertaken by the European Space Agency in partnership with NASA. The spacecraft will be launched in April 2023 and is expected to reach Jupiter by 2030, where it will spend at least 3 years orbiting the planet and studying its moons. One of the main objectives of the JUICE mission is to explore the possibility of life in our solar system. Scientists believe that Jupiter's three large ocean-bearing moons, Ganymede, Callisto, and Europa, could potentially support microbial life. The mission will carry instruments to study the composition and habitability of these moons, as well as their geology and surface features. In addition to studying the moons, the JUICE mission will also delve into Jupiter's complex environment in depth. The spacecraft will observe Jupiter's atmosphere, magnetic field, and radiation belts, providing valuable data on the workings of this giant planet. The JUICE mission is a complex and challenging project, requiring advanced technology and precision engineering. The spacecraft will be powered by solar panels and will use a combination of gravitational assists and aerobraking maneuvers to reach Jupiter. Once in orbit, the spacecraft will use its advanced instruments to study the planet and its moons. The JUICE mission is an exciting opportunity for scientists and space enthusiasts alike. It promises to unlock many of the mysteries surrounding the formation and evolution of our solar system, and could potentially shed light on the possibility of life beyond Earth. With the launch happening soon, the world is eagerly anticipating the arrival of this groundbreaking mission. Aren't you excited? That's all for this video. Thanks for watching. Do you have any other mind-blowing facts you want to share? Let us know in the comments below. I'll see you next time on the channel.